Hello everyone. So it's time for another video. Today is about Burgmann upgrades. And before starting this video, I want to thank Fernando from Chile, also known as Burgmann Chill, for his awesome videos about his upgrades. And honestly, my upgrade was mostly inspired by his upgrades. So let's jump into the video. Starting from GVF266 Airflow windscreen, which is number one in my favorite list. I think it's the best upgrade you can take for a Burgmann 400. Bike with this screen feels like a different bike. Less buffering compared to stock screen, better hand protection, adjustable height. Screen can be adjusted without any additional tools, simply by releasing two levers and moving spoiler by hand. I mostly ride with screen in lever position. I use highest position of the screen only on highways and to protect my passenger from strong front winds. Here on my way to Prague, you can see how many bugs has ended their life on a raised windscreen instead of my visor. Also, passenger feel less buffering around head. Spoiler creates kind of air bubble for rider, which protects nicely from rain, but unless I'm on highway, I use it in lower position. And wider windshield body provide better protection for hands during cold weather. On a hot day in the city or on twists when you need a bit more fresh air and better visibility, you can set screen to lowest position and enjoy wind in your face. My next is Denali D2, nice and expensive LED lights manufactured in USA. Really small, bright and low power. They have two different lenses which you can install. I use 15 degree lens on the left side to light things in distance and 30 degree on the right side to better see roadside. Lights comes with waterproof on-off switch, all wiring and possibility to set up as always full light or 50% brightness with low beam and switching to 100% with high beam. Camera can show how they perform in real life, but reflective road signs and road markings on highway can be seen few hundred meters away. I use them all the time to provide light triangle for upcoming traffic as spotlights. Braking wave discs. My original discs worn out, so I replaced them with braking. They break not that hard as original from Suzuki, but shape looks really stylish and sporty, and they have better ventilation, which is a plus when riding two up in mountain twisties, where I can brake for 13 km when go down from mountains. Leowin's Gran Turismo exhaust. No power improvements, 5 kg weight savings, nice sound and legal for road use. But most important thing, it's a beauty of Italian design. Just take a few seconds and appreciate how cool bike looks with this pipe. Coming to luggage, I have GVS setup, which is E531 rear rack and TB531 backrest. This setup is for monocoque cases, which are touring oriented, as opposed to monolock system, which is for city use. Juve claims that Rack can handle 10 kg versus 3 for monologue. That's total weight of case itself with luggage. Rubber parts that absorb vibration wear through time and need to be periodically replaced. Also, stop light wiring for case is mounted to the rack. Backrest have minimum clearance with seat when seat is opening. My case of choice is 47-liter GV V47NN with S150 universal rack. Case is big enough to carry two M-size jet helmets or one full-face helmet. I usually store my helmets in underseat storage, and top case I use for transporting my clothes during trips because it's easier to carry top case to hotel room, or I use it for any kind of stuff I need to move. Case have clearance with backrest, and even with high vibration on bad roads, doesn't touch it. I use universal rack occasionally in touring to mount backpack with high vis waterproof cover, especially when riding during rain or fog, or to mount new helmet purchased in another country when you simply have no additional space where to put it. GVE135 LED stoplights are designed specifically for this case. They are bright enough and visible for truck and bus drivers from above. And quick dashboard check. Breakaway cruise control. This is a throttle lock that I use only on highways a few times a year. Lock can be activated by pushing engage button, and to release the lock you can either push trigger or apply front brake lever. When you're riding highway for multiple hours, it's really nice to move your hand from handlebar and stretch a little bit. Poly heaters PH400 are unusual heaters that are mounted inside the handlebar, so they can be used with any original or aftermarket grips. Two level of heating, good enough for temperatures down to freezing, but if you ride in a cooler conditions, it's better to consider heated gloves. Garmin Zumo 590 mount, which came with GPS unit itself in a box. Mounted on a mirror with RAM ball mounts and powered directly from a scooter battery. SV Motec mount and Bikemaster USB. This mount was previously used for Zumo GPS, but now it's used for USB charging kit. USB has SAE connector to prevent battery drain and has 2.1 ampere charge, which is enough to charge power hungry GPS. Now I'm using it to charge my vape or intercom units on a stop. Last but not least, AirHawk seat cushion. Borgman seat is a couch comparing to motorcycles, but even it can be rough after long rides on bad roads. AirHawk is must-have piece of upgrade for touring, for both rider and passenger. I cannot ride more than 200 km without it, but with AirHawk I managed to get my longest ride, which was 18 hours. All my long European trips happened thanks to this cushion, when I was able to write on average 10 hours a day, and sometimes even more. But this cushion is useful not only on bike. I use it every day on my office chair and regret nothing. So does my cat. Borgmann is really capable touring machine, and upgrades make it even better. Please leave a comment about your favorite upgrade, put a like, and feel free to subscribe. See you in the next video. Bye!